we asked the experts, what do we need to make our infrastructure high tech? First thing they said is you have to have a very robust 5G wireless foundation. And so we currently have 5G signal here right now. We've got smart street lights out there that are able to talk to everything. And we added video cameras that have data analytics, object detection, the ability to communicate with cars.
Our cameras in our event space have facial recognition.
Commissioner.
Hey, Kim, good to
see
you again.
Hello, nice to see you.
Yeah, thanks for coming over.
Thank you for doing this.
Yeah.
What would you say has changed in the past, say, 5 years from when people really didn't know what 5G was to where we're starting to see it being rolled out in some cities now?
I think Americans are really starting to get excited about 5G. If you think back on our own lives 10 years ago when we were shifting from 3G to 4G, it unleashed this new wave of innovation, including ride-sharing apps that have transformed how we get across the town. We're seeing that same thing happen with 5G, artificial intelligence, smart cities. None of that's gonna work without 5G.
One of the major things that you've done with the so-called small cell order is to limit the fees that cities can charge to a telecom provider for placing an antenna on a right-of-way, a telephone pole, for example. You've also put a cap on the amount of time they can take to look at an application and make that decision. Why did you go that route?
One of the things that I did was get outside of DC to learn about what cities and states and communities were doing to accelerate infrastructure build, what was working, what wasn't working. And what I found is about 20 states had passed these small cell bills that did the types of things that you talked about. And we've worked through these in our FCC proceeding. We had to apply a law passed by Congress which said state and local authorities can't effectively prohibit the provision of service, and we applied that law in light of the new technologies that are coming out. And what we're seeing after that decision is an acceleration of infrastructure build.
We're going to one of the locations where one of the wireless telecommunications companies has installed a small cell wireless device. The guts of the machine is the box that's here at the lower level, and then the antennas at the top. There's at least 25 that I know of in the city deployed already. Industry was way ahead of local government and government response for deployment of small cell wireless. And they started coming to the city with applications to deploy their devices and their facilities before we knew what was going on. And when we finally caught on to what was going on, we're like, wait, you're digging up our right-of-way and you're not paying us. That's not right. I think it is important to vindicate the rights of local government to govern. And what the FCC's order does is censor that conversation and say, this is the end, this is your answer, deal with it. And that fundamentally, I think, is an attack on governance and on local government particularly.
Hi.
So good to see
you.
So nice to see you.
All right, come on back.
I talked to Commissioner Carr yesterday, and one of the points that he made is that when the order was adopted, already 20 states had implemented some sort of small cell order to streamline the process for the cities. And so the order was simply finding the consensus of what those states had already done and what there was already an appetite for and making it a national policy. Do you agree with that?
Well, I think it's terrific that some of our state legislatures have taken this issue up because we do need to streamline the process for deployment. But I don't think sitting here in Washington, we have the right to tell cities what to do.
So it's interesting because it's the very cities that carriers want to deploy with their high band spectrum, New York, LA, Seattle, Portland. But those are actually some of the cities that are suing the FCC over this order.
We've also got mid-sized cities and small towns in Iowa, in Washington State, in Nebraska. In other words, they all have in common something pretty fundamental. They want to be able to have a say in how this gets deployed in their own backyard. We just got to figure out how to give them a role in this process, and we're going to be more successful. But until we do, we're just going to spend a lot of time in court.